It would be their second consecutive final here, and the crowd absolutely love their beach volleyball, that's for certain. So much has been done for the game by Marketa Slukova, Barbara Hermanova. And now it's time for Perisic and Schweiner to try and make their second final in succession. Klasilnikov gets us underway with a serve into the net. You have to think for Russia, well, they will be very, very happy with their return to form at the perfect time. There is only one more event after this one before the Olympic Games in Tokyo, and that's in Kastad, Switzerland, another iconic venue at the beginning of July. So there's almost a month in between competitions, a chance for players to rest and get back onto the training court. Oleg Stoyanovsky, the blocker, had a great youth career with Artem Yazukin. To the line, though, Perisic with great feet and a very good arm. His pair were fantastic yesterday in their quarterfinal match. Well, they came past Daniele Lupo and Paolo Nicolai, the silver medalists from Rio. But that's Stoyanovsky seeing just about everything that the Czech pair are trying to lay out in defense. A cross-court block. Perisic sat on the line. Stoyanovsky sees it and just chips over the top. Well, for Klasilnikov, played a long time with Konstantin Semenov, that partnership that finished just after the Rio Olympics, where they took that fourth place. Semenov will be going to the games in July with Ilya Leshchikov. So both players have split and recently found happiness again, which is what we like to see. Stoyanovsky off the net. The first pass is off. He gets caught underneath the ball, and there's the first break of this one to the home team. Just shows that even the biggest of players in this game can lose height on the net when they don't pass well. Serving to the center again, trying to take the angles away from Stoyanovsky. Do not take the line, though. Big hammer from the big Russian. First change of ends in this stunning, stunning arena for beach volleyball. This, the first of six matches today. Two semi-finals, followed by the two medal matches in the women's competition. Perisic just moves the block of Stoyanovsky before knuckling over the top of the block. Very good, just trying to unsettle Stoyanovsky early on. Move the big blocker. A game of cat and mouse, really. After the medal matches from the women, we have the medal matches from the men. So a feast of beach volleyball coming our way from Ostrovets. Stoyanovsky finds a side out, this time back across the body. Kicks out this time. Comes in showing angle and just beats Perisic to the outside hand. Klasilnikov and Semenov took two silver medals in European Championships. But it was this team that won that historic first World Championship for Russia against Tolle Wickler from Germany. Tolle Wickler haven't had the easiest of times on the World Tour. Appendicitis for Clemens Wickler at the beginning of this season, and now a sprained ankle for Julius Tolle. So he hope to see them back at full fitness playing together soon. It was Wickler this week playing with a different partner in Armin Dollinger. And as we head towards the Olympic Games, it just shows how open it is. Even the beach volley Vikings have lost three games in 2 weeks, and that very rarely happens considering, well, their record in Mexico was losing six in around 110. That one's long from Stoyanovsky. Mm-hmm. with the return to form from Klesilnikov, Stoyanovsky, they do have a habit of winning the big events in 2019. They took two wins, and they happened to be two five-star victories in Hamburg and also the World Tour Finals. Klesilnikov doing what Klesilnikov does, and that's, well, he's one of the most, if not the most, dynamic left sides in the game. He kicks out, he drives back in to the cross court and hammers past the defense once more. Klesilnikov serving on the long angle to Perisic. Back set, that's making the blocker work once more, but Klesilnikov darts the other way, has a chance in transition to bring this back square. Schweiner sees it, but it's too good from Klesilnikov. It's the way that Perisic and Schweiner play. They move the blocker even on the long angle. There was once upon a time where you'd only run a reverse set when you really served inside because your weight was already naturally going behind the setter. But now it's all about running the big guys around. Short on David Schweiner. Big play from Klesilnikov. Overpass and the control there from Schweiner, world class. That ball's coming over. It's a good meter and a half off the net for Schweiner. He has to just readjust himself. Here's the side out phase of the game. Klesilnikov getting underneath the ball, but that's not an easy skill to adjust the feet and put the ball away to the line. Lines open this time. And that's Klesilnikov doing good bits of work off the ball once again. Certainly has been a tactic for teams against Vyacheslav Klesilnikov to move him inside and try and stop him hitting the cross-court angles. We saw this yesterday from Schreiner going high off the hands at every opportunity. From the centre this time, a couple of steps in from Stoyanovsky, and he tries to work it back. Stoyanovsky's blocking a little bit more of the ball than what we thought there, trying to take absolutely everything. Ace from Schweiner, and you can hear the crowd getting fired up. Getting right behind their boys here. It's a fast-paced float serve. Too quick for Stoyanovsky. A change-up serve. Caught Stoyanovsky cold. Now they'll go back to Klesilnikov. That's exactly what happens. And it's a good side out from Klesilnikov, but the damage is done with the previous ace. It's a really good break. From Perisic Schweiner. As they nudge towards the technical timeout here in Ostrava. Russia have won 22 golds on the World Tour. To think that Brazil have still won 200 is just phenomenal. The early dominance in the sport by Brazil and the USA. But now the European teams, especially on the men's side of the game, have caught up and overtaken in many ways. Reverse flipper from Klesilnikov, second opportunity, just lifted over baby line. Stoyanovsky posting on social media last night that he knew this was going to be a tough game. Side out made to look fairly easy against the 6'7" block of David Schweiner. We go to the technical timeout here in Ostrava. Just 1 point between the two. Well, the question towards the Olympics, have Russia been out of form, or are they building something special for Tokyo? And what a story it's been for this team here from Czech Republic, going to their first Olympic Games. Great run of form. Top 10 finishes for the Minim Doha, the bronze medal in the Cancun Hub, where the World Tour was in Mexico for 3 straight competitions in 17 days. Now in stunning Strava. Quite a stunning summer's day here. Fulski, slightly frustrated with himself, is it's always tough to build rhythm behind the baseline after a timeout. Chance for your rhythm to leave you. Two missed serves in a row, so maybe that's a thing that's contagious around here. Miss serve for a miss serve, and nothing's really changed since the technical. Perisic Schweiner, certainly a top 10 team when it comes to results, but they have broken into the top five, really, in terms of form over the last few weeks. They're number one seed for this competition, but that's because they are the host team. Showing line, chipping back angle, because Silnikov is running into block there. Stornowski had to come back onto the backcourt. And when the blocker goes into the backcourt, you can always, almost always anyway, expect the shot. Knuckle angle does damage. Perisic is really good at knuckling angle, and that's a sharp off-speed shot from the left-hand side from Russia. The reason why Perisic is using that knuckle from the inside position is because it's the easiest way to turn the ball with speed from the more central areas of court. Lightning strikes twice for Stojanovski. It's exactly the same serve as we saw post-technical. Stojanovski the target. Oh, huge hammer back angle. That's the Stojanovski we know very, very well on this tour. Once again, coming in quite straight, jumping back into the line, Schweiner, but no stopping that one, Perisic, that time. If you're a defender on this World Tour, there's a few swings, a few bits of offense that you really just have to let go. Reverse set this time. Pass the outside hand of Oleg Stojanovski from David Schweiner. They seem to find a way every single time here. They know exactly what they're doing. Move Stojanovski, look for the hands. Stojanovski frustrated. Huge moments. They love playing on home sand. It's a big, big serve down the line. Stojanovski feeling the heat, still moving. The ball rattles past him at speed. It's exactly what Perisic and Schweiner would have wanted. Russia have to go to a timeout because they're feeling the heat here in Ostrava. What a start for Andrei Perisic and David Schweiner. There's three from Stojanovski. This team led by Vyacheslav Nurka. And also former Estonian international Rivo Vesic. Saying last year and then planning to win the big ones, Russia. Everything periodized and planned for the big occasion. Andrei Perisic to get us back underway. The development of this team underneath the guidance of Andrea Tomatis. You hear them talking about their coach post-match interview yesterday. And they run a game based on angles and speeds and moving the blocker. They're very smart in the way when they set off the net to when they set on. Sometimes they just set a little bit more off than it, and it allows the attacker to go over the top of the block. This game not all about hitting hard all the time. It's about moving the ball around, having good vision and knowing when to look for the blocker and knowing when to look for the defender. Stoyanovsky, big play from Stoyanovsky once more. We've seen him hammer that angle a couple of times here. Good luck, Perisic. It's interesting to see these blockers get served more and more on the run. There's a time where teams would keep the ball away from the blocker due to the height, but it's almost been figured out that the extra demands of spin serving with getting served and also trying to make blocks is quite the difficult job for any player in the world. Ooh, two balls being seen very early. Cheeky from Klesilnikov. Good reactions from Stoyanovsky. Opportunity with the free ball. Andre Perisic from the right side goes back to the angle. In or out is going to be the question. It's gone the wrong side of the sideline. Opportunity comes knocking for Russia. Not many errors so far from Perisic and Schweiner, but one at key time. Great read from Perisic on that standing two ball. Close, but not this time. They might rue that miss opportunity in the latter stages of this one. Not when Schweiner's coming in and turning the ball away. So good from David Schweiner. Fronts up Stoyanovsky. Klesilnikov bewildered by that one. Big serve from Schweiner. Klesilnikov hitting off the net. Klesilnikov hitting off the hands. Klesilnikov knows the situation he's in there. He's slightly off the net, so it makes it more difficult for the blocker to get that line and to penetrate over. It's much easier for a blocker to make a block when the ball is set closer to the net. Perisic from the left side this time, block from Stoyanovsky, but his body language tells us absolutely everything we need to know. Again, can't quite seal with the outside hand. This is a reoccurring issue for Stoyanovsky. They're moving him around and they're just changing the speed of everything they're doing with their arm as well. Big in transition. The opening set goes to the Czech pairing of Andrej Perisic and David Schweiner. An unbelievable start in their third Final Four here on home sand in succession. They've moved Oleg Stoyanovsky around. Klesilnikov has struggled to really initiate himself into the game. Perisic and Schweiner take the opener here, 21-17. Wow, short on Stoyanovsky, struggling for rhythm once more and swinging into that line really nicely. Andre Perisic. Their growth as a team, frightening on this World Tour. Their consistency getting more and more week on week. And the crowd give them an extra 10% at least. There's the stats on this, the opener. More errors from Russia. That really does stick out. No blocks to either side. That's a scary stat when you think Schweiner and Stoyanovsky are so big on them. Three digs apiece. The aces. Two aces. Perisic and Schweiner. So back underway then here in the second set of this men's first semi-final, with the winner meeting the winner of Netherlands and Brazil in the second semi-final coming up after this one. Both teams have to click the reset button here as we get underway. Doesn't matter what's happened in the first. Perisic. Talk about hitting the reset button. So cool, calm and collective, Andre Perisic. Good couple of steps to the ball. Very, very smooth with the arm. Kolesilnikov now the target. So there has been a change-up. Steps out and the crowd goes so quiet when Russia win a big point. Almost quite funny. Stoyanovsky. He fires one wide, but that's a better serve than what we were seeing in the opener for Stoyanovsky, because he's starting to find a bit of power and it's close to the sideline. Better than the ones that were finding the net early on. Stoyanovsky looks to the gap. There's a late move from Perisic and Schweiner. Looks as if there might have been a net touch against Kolesilnikov. First break goes to Perisic, Schweiner in set two as well. Wow. Well, that win in Doha was some performance against Guto and Evandro from Brazil. Taylor Crabb, Jake Gibb took the bronze, and Phil Dalhauser and Nicky Sen took fourth place. Both of those American teams going to the Olympic Games after all the drama this week. Taylor Crabb's brother Trevor needed to win this competition with Tri Born to get their way back into the Olympic Games, but they fell at a ninth place. The cut shot's a good one. Czech Republic lead by one at the change of ends, showing a lot of line and then just pouring it back to the angle. It's been an exciting race in the men's side of things. Multiple teams could have still qualified for the Olympics right up until yesterday. David Schweiner will be at the Olympics, and hopefully he's serving and blocking the way that he is today. Pepper Stoyanovsky right to the line. It's too quick once again. Too accurate as well. They are dialed in here. Well, for Latvia's Alexander Samoylov's Janis Schmedins, they fell to a ninth place to Paolo Nicolai Daniele Lupo. Yes, the second set was colossal, 30-28, but at the same time, if they would have won that game, they would have qualified for the Olympic Games. They needed a fifth, and they needed the Netherlands pairing of Varenhorst and Van der Velde not to medal this week, and they got knocked out yesterday in the quarterfinals to their fellow countrymen. Good tall from Stoyanovsky, moving Schweiner this time and going off the outside hand. Good change up from Russia. And whilst it's a game to really remember for the neutral, where the Netherlands versus the Netherlands. Braumussen already qualified for the games, but looking to return to form. They beat their friends and fellow countrymen, and in theory, for the time being, stopped them going to the Olympic Games. Here comes the boom here, though. Stoyanovsky sitting into the sharp angle late. What a dig that is. From Andre Perisic, just one thing to make a dig like that off an absolute rocket from Oleg Stoyanovsky. But to settle yourself, to put the ball away offensively, we're talking a completely different game. Unreal. Czech lead by two, change of ends once more, and it's another inspired performance so far from Perisic and Schweiner. Let's just put it that way. Another miss serve from Oleg Stoyanovsky. Count at least four or five of them throughout this game. And see that the frustration is starting to mount up on the Russian blocker. Six-time a winner on the World Tour. Krasilnikov operates away from the body once again, and it's a swing that he has when he passes well. Krasilnikov sees the blocker, goes away from the body. Perisic beaten. Very good from the Russians. Krasilnikov now going for the float serve. And that's just as big from Davidge Fine. No digging that one. Krasilnikov is lining up with the power line of the spiker. He's a little bit inside, and then he's beaten back out to the sideline. Looking for medal number six on the World Tour today. Stoyanovsky goes for the sharpest of angles, but just to see if the ball's inside. It is a little bit inside on Stoyanovsky, which means he's going to lose some accuracy. So there's a timeout. Russia not looking so happy here. We'll have a look at the service errors. I counted four or five, but more than that from Stoyanovsky. Six service errors. Final with 71 attack efficiency, but Krasilnikov at 80%, which is a great return for the Russian defender. And that's why they're going after Stoyanovsky a little bit more. He's missing serves. He's having to block, and he's also having to side out. There's a big workload going on to Stoyanovsky, let's put it that way. Russia looking for win number five as a pair in 19 events, but they're way off the pace here this morning. Back underway, Schweiner chasing in. Stoyanovsky stopped from Davidge Schweiner. They're running away with this one. They're looking to back up the win in Doha with another finals performance here. Good hands from Schweiner. 5-point game now. There's still room for Russia to improve and to come back here, although 4 points is still quite a long way. The technical timeout coming up next. Russia will want this to be back at three. They won't want a 5-point deficit going into the second half of the second set, having lost the opener. But they have to go in five down. A good cross line from China comes in, looking angle, and just turns it away from the line. It's a sharp approach. It's a good brush back from the big Czech blocker. One of the form teams of the season on this World Tour, looking to top the podium for the second time. Russia, well, you'd expect to see them in more Final Fours than we have done recently. It's good to see them back on the big stage. When you talk about teams that could win the Olympic Games, can't go very far away from Russia, Norway, Germany were all strong in 2019, the last full season on the World Tour, but now there's a new breed of teams coming through. Qatar have been sublime the last few weeks. And also Perisic and Schweiner. I've said the pandemic did them good. It got them time to work on their strategy with their coach. Into the angle. Stoyanovsky stopped this time. with From Russia Who Beats, Piotr Kantor and Bartosz Wozniak from Poland in the quarterfinals. The winners from last week in Sochi. That was a win that got them to the Olympic Games. And, well, speaking to their coaching staff in the week from Poland, they're just so happy with how they found their rhythm. Spiros Karachalios, the head coach, said they're full focus, Kantor Wozniak, for this event, because mathematically it wasn't safe and they needed that podium in Russia. But now they are mathematically safe. The Chilean cousins taking the last spot. Big from Stoyanovsky. Miss serve number 7 from Stoyanovsky. He has to start sinking some soon. There's a good start for Stoyanovsky. Russians currently number 2 in the Olympic ranking. They'll go as a second seed. They qualified for the Olympic Games by winning the World Championships in Hamburg. Other teams that qualified early with Daniele Lupo, Paolo Nicolai from Italy, Plavins and Toksh from Latvia. And also the host nation, Japan. Schreiner sides out once more. No matter what they do here, Russia just can't buy a dig. They cannot buy a block. The offense, led by the passing of the Czech team, too good. Stoyanovsky, good delay in the blocking. Watching everything, Schreiner. Jumbo from Stoyanovsky. Great delay in the block from Schreiner. He's always watching through the net, he's not watching the ball, although he'll be aware of where the ball is, but that... was too accurate from Stoyanovsky. And the frustration again showing from Stoyanovsky. Miss serve number 8. Just shows that if they keep missing serves, Russia, they're never going to build pressure on the side-out game of the opposition. Stoyanovsky once more from the right side. Finds one back angle. Recovery's good, but it's unfortunate for Navitschvainer, who can't quite turn and react. Transition setting is such a tough skill, but especially when the ball's pinging off the net like that. Check by 4. 4 will do it for them. Does that just touch the sideline from Navitschvainer? Quite possibly so. Delicate, accurate from the blocker. Surely now. The Czech pair will be playing against the winner of the Netherlands or Brazil. Chase to the line. Great speed, good agility from Perisic. Vasilnikov parks in the power line, as does Andrei Perisic. Big rally this one. It has to go the way of Russia if they want to take this to 3. And it does. 1 saved. Russia looking for the crowd to appreciate their work, but take some time to draw the applause from the locals. Vasilnikov showing power to start with. Accuracy in the second phase of the game. back set, turning angles. This is why they're so difficult to play against. Passing well, Perisic. The back set followed by the cut shot is a difficult play. They almost have this playbook with Andrea Tomatis that it's more like an American football team at times from Perisic and Schweiner. There's a mistake from Stojanovski. Match point now for Andre Perisic and David Schweiner. What a performance once more in Ostrava. Russia, well, undefeated to this point, but now 6 match points for the Czech Republic on home sand. And there you have it, first time of asking. David Schweiner dives into the angle, makes the block, and it's the champions from Doha who go into their second final of the season here on home sand in Ostrava. Another fantastic performance from David Schweiner, and Andre Perisic send the fans wild. Their third Final Four in succession in Ostrava. They've beaten the world champions 21-17, 21-14. You have to feel that Russia never really got out of first gear. The serving let them down at times. There's also some marvellous work. That's how it finished. David Schweiner diving into the angle on Stojanovski, sending Ostrava to an absolute ruckus. Just waiting to go down courtside. Here they are. Před zápasem asi ani nepředstavovali.
Rozhodně ne. Tak hráli jsme proti mistrům světa, takže jsme věděli, že to bude strašlivě těžký. A i když to možná podle skóre tak nevypadalo, tak si myslím, že až do závěru jsme si nemohli být jistý, jestli ten zápas vyhrajeme, protože Rusové jsou pověstní tím, že mají vynikající servis i v těch právě těžkých momentech. A jsem strašně rád, že jim dneska ten servis moc nelepil a my jsme byli schopni si odstrátovat ten zbytek.
Gratuluji k tomu postupu, což jsem zapomněl ještě říct, do finále. Vypadá to, že taktická připravenost možná rozhodovala, že jste zvládli i tak brzký ranní zápas, na což jste si stěžovali, že tak brzo ráno hrát je trošku problém.
Tak ona, ta taktická příprava je připravená dobře vždycky, akorát my to nejsme schopní provést. No. Ale my jsme věděli, že, jak už Ondra zmiňoval, Rusové hrozně dobře podávají a už vlastně v předchozích vzájemných zápasech tak nám dokázali, že dokážou dát 3 esa v řadě a otočit tak zápas. Takže do poslední chvíle to nebylo rozhodnutý.
Z vaší strany samozřejmě skvělý výkon, to nechci nějak podceňovat, ale Rusové asi nepředvedli to, na co jste se připravovali možná.
Rozhodně ne. Já si myslím, že od začátku se na tom centerkoutu necítili dobře, jak na útoku, tak na servisu. A na tom je ta hra založená, takže to si myslím, že byl hlavní klíč. A samozřejmě domácí atmosféra, protože to publikum je úplně úžasný.
Tímhle postupem teda srovnáváte výkon z roku 2019, což je stříbro. Je to splněné minimum, nebo to minimum je zlato?
Asi minimum to určitě nebylo ani před turnaje. My jsme říkali, že budeme spokojení s čtvrtfinále. Tohle je těžký nadplán a jestli z toho bude zlatá medaile, tak my budeme jedině rádi.
Možná byste chtěli poděkovat i divákům, kteří vás podporovali až doteď a budou muset předvést podobný výkon i odpoledne.
Rozhodně, já doufám, že dorazí v co největším počtu a ještě bych chtěl jenom dodat.
Hodně štěstí.
A very, very happy Czech team and a phenomenal performance from Andre Perisic and David Schweiner. He did not make a final mistake in that game, is what they were saying.